ठीक
ठीक है सर।
है, विल
हेलो
स्टार्ट
एवरीवन
विदे,
एंड शैल वी स्टार्ट सर।
या प्लीज,
हेलो एवरीवन एंड वेलकम टू अनदर सेशन ऑफ द ग्लोबल टॉक सीरीज, अ जॉइंट वेंचर ऑफ जेसी बिलासपुर एंड एलुमनाई ऑफ बिलासपुर जेसी दैट इज एक्टिव। आई डीपी सिंह, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर जेसी बिलासपुर, फील प्रिविलेज्ड टू एक्सटेंड अ वार्म वेलकम टू ऑल गेस्ट, प्रिंसिपल सर, एचओडीज, फैकल्टीज एंड अटेंडेंट्स। We feel honored to have with us Dr. Vijay Kumar Dalla, Assistant Professor, NIT Jamshedpur, and also the presenter of today's talk. With equal pleasure, I would like to welcome Mr. Umesh Srivastava, Regional Coordinator of Global Talks, and just a little housekeeping before we start. If you have any question during the presentation, please type them into chat box. We will bring them up during presentation. Our topic for today's presentation is Kinematics and Dynamics of a Robot, presented by Dr. Vijay Kumar Dalla, Assistant Professor, NIT Jamshedpur, and our 2006 batch alumni of Mechanical Engineering. He has completed from IIT Roorkee in year 2016 and Masters from IIT Bombay in the year 2008. His area of research interests are robotics, dynamics and control, bond graft techniques, fatigue, fracture and failure analysis of materials. From last many years, he's contributing to the engineering community and entire society as a proficient engineer, a good researcher, and as an educator. He also entitles many research publications in different international and national journals and conferences. He is also a regular reviewer of different international journals. Sir, I extend a warm welcome to you. Now, leadership is the capacity to translate vision into reality, and all of us are fortunate to work under the leadership of the same capacity. I would like to take this opportunity to invite our principal, sir, Dr. B.S. Chawla, to say a few words in welcome of our guest.
Thank you, Deepi.
Welcome, sir.
Professor Dr. Vijay Dalla, our alumni, 2006 mechanical, our very senior alumni who are present in today's Global Talk series, Sri A.K. Mukherjee Sahab, 1980 mechanical, former director, Bhabha Atomic Research Center, Bombay, Sri Anil Rane Sahab, 1980 mechanical, presently acting as consultant, who has held various senior positions in different sectors and accomplished all the tasks very successfully, Sri Rane Saab. Sri Kamal Mundra sir, 1980 mechanical, to whom we had listened last time on power scenario. He is former GM NTPC. He has also spared time for today's talk. And another respected alumni, that time gold medalist, Sri Shesh Narayan Bakshi ji, 1980 electrical batch, former GM, Bhilai Steel Plant, that is SIL. I welcome you all, sir. Sri Umesh Srivastava ji is there, who is national coordinator. He is vice president Ultratech, who is taking all the pains for making this show a very successful. My colleagues, Professor J.K. Agrawal ji, HOD Mechanical, Dr. M.R. Mishram ji, HOD Electronics and Telecom, all faculties, and Master of Ceremony of today's program, Professor Vivek, Professor Deepi, and their team, all my dear students, and all other alumni worldwide who are witnessing this. I welcome you all to this show, to this talk series. Sri Vijay Dalla, who is acting as an assistant professor in NIT Jamshedpur, that is a matter of pride for us that one of our colleague, one of our student is holding senior position in a reputed institute. And he is very active in R&D and doing a lot of work in that college, in that series only. He himself came forward and agreed that I'll be the first person. I want to be the first person to talk to my juniors and I want to work for my alma mater. Thank you, Professor Dalla. You have chosen a very good topic. This is quite relevant and in very much demand, that is kinematics and dynamics of a robot. Today's talk will definitely give a lot of insight to all the listeners to understand how robot works. With these words, I wish success to this talk. I thank to all my colleagues who spared their time to attend this program. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, sir. Now, I would like to request Dr. G.K. Agrawal, sir, Head of Department Mechanical Engineering, to deliver this speech of welcome. Sir, please.
आज के कार्यक्रम के मुख्य वक्ता डॉक्टर विजय कुमार दल्ला, संस्था के प्राचार्य डॉक्टर बी एस चावला, साथी प्राध्यापक गण एवं उपस्थित पूर्व एल्यूमनी, जब भी कोई शिष्य इतनी योग्यता या काबिलियत हासिल कर ले कि उसके ज्ञान का लाभ छात्रों को, शिक्षकों को और समाज को मिलता है, तो गुरु द्वारा दी गई शिक्षा जो है सफल हो जाती है। आज हम हमारे कॉलेज के, हमारे विभाग मैकेनिकल के भूतपूर्व छात्र 2006 बैच डॉक्टर विजय कुमार दल्ला, जो कि सहायक प्राध्यापक है एनआईटी जमशेदपुर में, एक बहुत ही सामयिक टॉपिक, रिलेवेंट टॉपिक, इमर्जिंग टॉपिक रोबोटिक्स, काइनामेटिक एंड डायनामिक्स ऑफ रोबोटिक्स पर व्याख्यान देंगे। और जैसा हम देख रहे हैं कि इस कोरोना महामारी के समय बहुत सारे हॉस्पिटल में, बहुत सारे अस्पताल में ये रोबोट का उपयोग कर रहे हैं कोरोना पेशेंट को दवाई देने के लिए, ये सब करने के लिए। तो इस तरह से वो पूरे रोबोटिक्स के बारे में बहुत विस्तार से छात्रों को बताएंगे। और छात्रों से मेरा यही अनुरोध है कि उनके तकनीकी व्याख्यान को तो ध्यान से सुने ही, साथ ही हमारे जो छात्र जो कड़ी मेहनत से या अपने लगन से ये मुकाम हासिल किए अपने करियर में, उनसे भी प्रेरणा। तो मैं इन्हीं शब्दों के साथ आज के प्रमुख वक्ता डॉक्टर विजय कुमार दल्ला का स्वागत करता हूं और उन्हें आज के व्याख्यान के लिए आमंत्रित करता हूं। धन्यवाद।
थैंक यू सर। नाउ विदाउट फर्दर एडू, वी विल टर्न द टाइम ओवर टू आवर प्रेजेंटर डॉक्टर विजय कुमार दल्ला। सर, वी रिक्वेस्ट यू टू स्टार्ट द सेशन।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर, प्रोफेसर बी एस चावला सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग।
आवर एलुमिनी मुखर्जी सर एंड आवर एचओडी मैकेनिकल डिपार्टमेंट जीसी बिलासपुर अग्रवाल सर एंड ऑल अदर माय डियर फैकल्टीज, रियली आई एम वेरी हैप्पी एंड होल नाइट आई कुड नॉट स्लीप प्रॉपरली। आई हैव टू गिव लाइक it was just like a pressure ki in my alma mater and someone invited me, so it's my duty to give my to perform my duty honestly and to the best what I can do. So regarding this robotics, it's a huge demanding subject. As I'm going to conduct two FDP that is sponsored by AICT, so you won't be believing, in each FDP program we are getting more than 5,000 registrations, and daily we are doing almost 10 to 20 emails for requisitions. Sir, please consider us. So obviously it's a good relevant topic, and as you know, it's very useful in the COVID-19 period. All over the world the people are using in different ways, like disinfectants, like caring of medical staff. Our main purpose is not generally our thinking is that robot it creates problem for employment. So this is the another aspect, but if we talk about the positive aspect, it can be utilized as the human being cannot reach, the robot can reach. Means it's a kind of helping the human being. So in this way we are taking this and we are getting the benefit of robotics in our society. So shall I start now?
Yes, sir, you may start.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you, sir.
So the topic name is kinematics and the dynamics of a robot. So firstly, a robot. Robot is a machine, you know, but which kind of machine is it? It is an automatic machine, that is also true, but which kind of automatic machine? This is the automatic machine which is a which can do multifunctional work and it can be reprogrammed. These only two key words differentiate from the other types of automation. Means robotics comes under the category of automation. Which category? Reprogrammable automation. Means now question is the CNC machine is a robot? No, it's not a robot. Because CNC machine can do only one kind of specific work, but robot can do a number of different kind of tasks. It can play sometimes for inspection in the industry, for assembling the components, for surgery, and for space missions. And there are a lot of number of applications. So this is regarding the robot. Again, robot is a automatic machine which is a reprogrammable and a multifunctional to do the manipulation kind of things. Manipulation means suppose welding, so holding the torque and welding following the path, the given path. Now the kinematics and the dynamics, you all are knowing the difference between these two. So in kinematics we deal about the motions, not the cause of the motion. What is the cause of motion? In the case of linear, there may be force, but in the case of rotational, there may be the angular, means torque. So without considering the effect of force and torque, if we consider only the motions, positions, velocities, accelerations of the manipulator, the kinematic study of the robot. Now in dynamic study, we involve both the motions and the cause of motion. The cause of motions means the forces and the torques. So this is regarding the topic of the kinematics and the dynamics of a robot. Sometimes we say robot as manipulator. So what is a manipulator? Manipulator is a mechanical structure of the robot. Okay, now this is regarding, before starting kinematics and the dynamics, we should know about some basics. So this is a introduction to robotics, in which we can see the various robots that we will, and now outline, so in which we are going to deal about what is the definition of a robot. There are number of definitions, but which one is the best one, and then the types of robot, then what are the applications means what are the various uses, then what is the history behind this technology, then what are the key components and the industrial applications, and then future scope. So that term robot, it was derived by a Czech novelist which is called Karel Čapek in 1920. It was like a drama, something was mimicking to someone. So from the robot, it was initially, the term was robota, then later robot. And initially the robot was only limited for industrial applications in industry, but nowadays we can see there are number of applications one can have it in their his room as pet. One can expand its application in space, like capturing the debris, like inspecting the pipeline and so on. Now the definition of robot: any machine made by one of our members, Robot Institute of America, means it is one kind of machine, nothing else. But which kind of machine? See, a robot is a reprogrammable, multifunctional manipulator designed to move material, parts, tools, or specialized devices through variable programmed motions for the performance of a variety of tasks. You can see here, this reprogrammable. So what is reprogrammable? You can see here, through variable programmed motions. Reprogrammable means it may, in between operations, we can change the sequence. The sequence of tasks, and for the performance of a variety of tasks, it defines this multifunctionality. And manipulator, as I told you, what is manipulator? Manipulator is the mechanical design of the robot, designed to move materials, parts, tools, or specialized devices. So what is that specialized devices? Like robot, firstly, what about different parts of robots? So robot will have its base. It may be movable, means mobile or fixed. And the arm, the robot arm, what we have. And a robot arm will consist of number of links, which will be jointed by the joint, which will be connected by the joint, and which will be powered by the motor. So manipulator, it will have its base arm, and the arm will have the number of links. Number of links will be connected by the joint, and the joint will be powered by the motors. And the end of the robot, that is wrist, like our wrist. And the suppose if we compare our hand, so up to wrist will be the part of robot, and these fingers will be like end effectors, so that the robot can capture, the robot can handle the things. That is known as end effector. So these specialized devices, so suppose welding torque is the example of a specialized device where we can attach the welding torque to the wrist of the manipulator. So this definition is given by Robot Institute of America in 1979. So the term was coined by Carol Capek in 1920. It comes from the one novel, and the definition is, you always remember, whenever if you are going to define a robot, you always use the two keywords, reprogrammable and multifunctional. These are the types of robots. The first one, manipulator. So this is the fixed manipulation. Sorry, the fixed robot. Yeah, you can say fixed manipulator. The robot base will be fixed. This will be applied for industrial applications. And you can see the legged robot. The just like what we have leg, the robot will have also the leg. And the leg, we have only two. The robot may have number of legs. Here you can see the four-legged. And see, the each leg has two links, and the joint, this one will be the joint one, and this one will be joint two. Now the other kind of robot is the wheeled robot. Here the robot will be moving by the wheel. And the other application, so the other types, this was the second kind of types. This is the type of robots. Third, this is an example of autonomous underwater vehicle, and this is unmanned aerial vehicle. Unmanned means there is no human being. And this is autonomous underwater for inspection kind of things. Suppose there is a pipeline and there is some problem in the inside the pipeline. So this kind of robot can go and can inspect.
Excuse me, sir. Excuse me, sir. I want to disrupt you, sir. We cannot see the screen, sir. What you are showing now, we are unable to see the screen. You need to share the screen, sir.
You are not able to see?
No, sir. No, sir. We are not able to see.
Oh, no one.
No, sir. Till now we have not seen. So, sir, you can do share screen, sir, from that option.
I have done. Just wait, no.
Yes, sir.
From here I can share, no? From here.
Yes, sir. Now we can see your screen, sir.
Just a bit. Yeah, what about?
Just now we are able to see the screen of that robotics folder is there, and some PPTs are there in the list that is there, but PPTs has not opened up.
Oh, what is the problem?
So just click on the PPT.
Yes. Yeah, are you able to see?
No, sir. Sir, only folder.
We are able to see the list, but you need to double click, sir, on that robotics one or whichever file you want.
That I am doing actually. This one, see.
I think it is open in below taskbar.
Yeah, still you are not able to see?
No, sir.
Oh, excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
Sir, जो स्क्रीन हमको शो करना पड़ता है ना उसको जब हम स्क्रीन शेयर करते हैं ना तो वहाँ पर अलग अलग टास्क बनता है तो जिसको अपने को शो करना था उस टास्क पे आप क्लिक कर देंगे ना तो वो टास्क शो हो जाएगा स्क्रीन शेयर पे अभी ना इनका फोल्डर एक्टिव है
एट स्टार्ट सर ने जो स्क्रीन शेयर कर रहे हैं ना वो फोल्डर वाली स्क्रीन शेयर करी है हाँ ये राइट
थैंक यू मैम
So you just open this folder and go back to share screen and share that presentation one screen. You have to share it again. You have to share your screen again, sir.
Sir, after opening the PPT, please share the screen. Before opening the PPT, if you will share, it won't be watchable. After opening the PPT, please share the screen.
I think sir has left. I think he will join again.
Okay. After opening the PPT, if he will share, then we will able to watch
many options of screens were coming there you have to select that particular screen which is presenting the presentation
but wo will come if he will open the PPT first after opening after sharing screen he will open then it won't be able he will we won't be able to see First,
it will not even pop up in the
main share.
It will not even pop up in the dialog box, sir.
I think where sir has gone.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm not able to see it.
Yes, sir.
He's not able to show.
Okay.
Sir, first open the PPT, then share the screen.
Yeah, hello. Hello, yes. Madam.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, I'm not able to share. It's coming. Only meeting organizers can share.
Vivek, sir, there is a technical glitch.
Sir, 1 minute. Wait, I'll be. Wait, sir.
Okay.
I think now you will be able to share, sir.
Yeah.
So check it once.
Are you able to see?
No, sir. Actually, sir, you have to click on the screen share button, then a dialog will open, and on that there will be options like one to share the desktop, one to share the PDF, that robotics PDF. Click on that and it will be shown in the screen.
So first, stop sharing. Now just go on to the share tab. There will be a pop-up box where a lot of screen we are showing. You have to select a particular PDF one screen.
No, sir. Not like that.
Okay.
The PDF is already open in your computer. You just have to click on the screen button. Then the option will be shown that you which thing you want to share. There will be stop sharing.
Just one.
Now you can click on the PDF. It will be shown.
Just open. Now the entire screen is showing.
So yeah, just open. It will be shown, I guess.
Yeah, it is visible, sir.
Sir, you can start, sir.
We can continue now.
Yeah, shall I start from beginning?
No, sir, not from beginning. You can start from that point only, sir.
Okay. So one second. The topic is kinematics and the dynamics of a robot. And a robot is a one kind of machine, automatic machine, which is a reprogrammable and a multifunctional. Means can do a lot of work by changing the program. And the kinematic means in which we deal only about motions, not the forces and the torque. But in the case of dynamic, we consider the both motions and the cause of motions. Now regarding definitions, type, usage, history, and what are the key components, then industrial applications, and what may be the future scope. And the robot was defined by the Karel Capek. The term was derived, the coined by the one novel. The robot in Czech is a word for worker or servant. See, now definition of robot. As I told you, a robot is a reprogrammable, multifunctional manipulator, and a manipulator is what? The mechanical structure of the robot. But sometimes we say either manipulator or robot. Designed to move. So what is the purpose of robot? To move material, parts, tools, or specialized devices. So for example, the welding torque comes under these specialized devices. Now, through variable programmed motions, means the motions we can change in between. Also, the performance of a variety of tasks. The robot is not limited to only one kind of work. Suppose CNC is limited to only one kind of work. That's why it is not known as robot. It is known as only automatic machine. Now, regarding types of robots, First one, manipulator. This is a industrial manipulator which is used for welding and painting kind of things, in which the robot base will be fixed. This is the example of legged robot. You can see what we have leg, the same robot will be having. And this is the wheeled robot. The base is not fixed while it's moving due to this wheel. And the third one, autonomous underwater vehicle. See, this can be used in underwater for repairing, for inspecting the pipe or other things. And this is unmanned aerial vehicle. Now, regarding its uses. See, the first use, the jobs that are dangerous for humans, इसको human being करना नहीं चाहते, कई ऐसे jobs होते हैं जिसको हम नहीं करना चाहते हैं, so robot can do. And the cleaning the main circulating pump housing in the nuclear power plant. It is very dangerous for us, so robot can do. And for welding robot, some kind of repetitive task. We got bored. Same kind of doing, we are doing the same kinds of things we are doing, and we are getting bored. So that's why we lost our interest. So for that, for that kind of work, the robot can do. The robot can do the repetitive kind of jobs. The repetitive jobs that are boring, stressful, or labor incentive intensive for humans. The third one, menial tasks that humans don't want to do, like cleaning the toilet. Regarding loss of robotics, this is given by the ACMO. This is given by the ACMO, and generally there are three laws. The law 0 and 1 are almost same. So we are focusing on three kinds of law. The first one, the robot may not injure a human being or through inaction. The first one thing is, this is for safety, our safety. The robot, under any circumstances, the robot should not harm the human being. Second one, law two, the robot must obey always the instructions given by the human being, but without compromising the first law. And the third law, a robot must protect its own existence as long as such protection doesn't conflict with a higher order law. Means, robot ko bhi apne aap ko bachaye rakhna hai, apna astitva bachaye rakhna hai, but not sacrificing with the safety of human, not by disobeying the orders of human being. ठीक है, तो first law कौन सा हो गया कि human being को कभी भी harm नहीं करना है, मनुष्य को कभी harm नहीं करना है. Second क्या हो गया, जो भी instructions दिया जाएगा human being द्वारा उसको हमेशा follow करना है. Third one, अपना भी अस्तित्व को बचाए रखना है, लेकिन उसके चक्कर में ह्यूमन बीइंग को किसी प्रकार से नुकसान नहीं होना चाहिए. उसके चक्कर में जो ह्यूमंस को ह्यूमंस द्वारा जो ऑर्डर्स दिया जाता है उसको ये डिसऑबे नहीं करना है. जस्ट लाइक जैसे आप रोबोट मूवी देखे होंगे, तो रोबोट मूवी में कैसे रोबोट बदमाश बन जाता है, ह्यूमन बीइंग का ऑर्डर नहीं मानता. ओके, सो now, history of robotics. the first industrial robot that is known as Unimate. It was given in 1954. The first programmable robot is designed by George Devol, who coins the term universal automation. He later shortens this to Unimation, which becomes the name of the first robot company. So Unimation is the first robot company, and it started in 1962. So what is the first name of the robot? The first robot was industrial robot, and the name is the Unimate robot. And what is the role of this Unimate? Originally automate the manufacture of TV picture tube. This is the work. This was the first work of the industrial robot. Means automating the manufacturing of TV picture tube. Now, then the Puma, the full name is Programmable Universal Machine for Assembly. Robot is developed by Unimation with a General Motors design support. It was developed in 1978. This one, and it is an industrial robot having 5 to 6 degrees of freedom. And what is degrees of freedom? In robotics, each active joint will have 1 degree of freedom. So what is the meaning of active joint? There may be passive joints. So what is that passive joints? The passive joint means the joint which will be not powered, which will be not equipped by the motor. Then again, active joints, passive joints. Active joints which will be powered by motor, passive joints which will be not powered by motor. And what is the degree of freedom in the case of robotics? Degree in generally, you know, there are 6 degrees of freedom, 3 for translations and 3 for rotations. So In space means in 3D. In 3D, there will be 6 degrees of freedom. In the case of robotics, each active joint play 1 degree of freedom. Okay. So better come to kinematics and dynamics. This is all about history of robotics and the knowledge base for robotics. What are the knowledge we require? Dynamic system modeling, feedback control, sensors. We should know about sensors, signal conditioning, actuators, hardwares, and it's interfacing, then computer programming. These are the all required things. We should know about these things. And these are the key components, like it will have sensors. Sensors for? Why sensors required? To get information about the joint positions or robot tip positions. Actuators, what is actuators? Suppose if we compare with our human body, so muscles are actuators. But in the case of robot, what are the actuators? The motors are the actuators. And what is the purpose of actuators? Which? Rotates, which provides motion to the robot manipulator. And what is the controller? What is the purpose of controller? The controller regulate, means if there will be difference in reference trajectory and the actual trajectory, so controller will minimize that error. The error is denoted by small e is equal to the reference velocity minus the actual velocity. Now, what is that reference velocity? What is that reference trajectory in the robotics? We use trajectory. So what is that trajectory? The given path to the robot. भैया कि हमें ये वेल्डिंग करना है, यहाँ से आपका स्ट्रेट लाइन फॉलो करना है फ्रॉम हियर, सो हियर, फ्रॉम हियर, फ्रॉम दिस स्टार्टिंग पॉइंट टू द एंड पॉइंट. सो दिस लिनियर द लाइन विल बी द गिवन पाथ. इन जनरल वी से द पाथ, बट देयर इज अ डिफरेंस बिटवीन द पाथ एंड ट्रेजेक्ट्री. द पाथ इज द टाइम इंडिपेंडेंट, बट trajectory is the time dependent. Means whatever the equations will be, that will carry the time variable. Okay, user interface and a manipulator linkage, then base. Manipulator linkage means that arm which will have number of links, user interface, then controller. We have to interface with the hardware and software. And regarding the robot base, fixed versus mobile. So if robot base will be fixed, so what will be, whatever the vibrations comes from the robot tip to the robot base will be absorbed by the ground. But in the case of mobile, that vibration will not be absorbed. That is the biggest problem in the case of mobile robot. That's why its dynamics becomes complex. Now this is regarding robot mechanism. So mechanical elements like a gear for connecting, for regulating power, minimizing or amplifying the power. Now sensors, obviously, like we can sense, and then we can behave according to our environment. So robot also can do. So for example, human senses, sight, sound, touch, taste, and smell. Robot sensors measure robot configurations. Now, what is configuration? What is configuration? Configuration means the pose of the manipulator. And what is the pose? Pose means the position and the orientation of the robot. So configuration is the position plus orientation of the manipulator. So robot sensors measure robot configurations, conditions, and its environment, and then sends such information to robot controller. So why sensors are required? So that we get information. Where is our robot tip? Where is the joint? If the robot tip is not following the orders, not following the given path, then the controller can control and can minimize that error. This is the vision sensors, like what we can see, what we can walk, robot can also do. Those sensors, why it is required? Suppose for cleaning the glass window, we have to do two things. First one, cleaning from one point to the another point, and maintaining the pressure. If we don't maintain, so robot will crack the glass and there will be failure. Proximity sensor for avoiding obstacle, and for it senses the objects, senses the distance. Tilt sensors, it is to balance a robot. The purpose is to balance a robot. Then actuators. These are the types of actuators. Generally, DC motors are used. And see here, actuators / muscles. So if we compare with human being, our muscles are the actuators. And these are the types of actuators: hydraulic, pneumatic, electrical. This is the storage hardware. This is for computational hardware. This is for interfacing with the hardware and the software. Now, what are the various applications of robots? Like, it can be used in agriculture, automobile, construction, entertainment, healthcare, etc. Now, we want this robot can be used in space. It can be used in hazardous environments. It can be used for surgery. It can also be used in military for defense work. It can be used as pet at the room. Now, what are the features of robots? The most demanding area other than a robot is now artificial intelligence. Just like what we can do, what we can think. So what we have characteristics, that characteristics also can be achieved by the robot. So that is the artificial intelligence. Now, future of robots, this is the second kind of autonomy. Then humanoid robot. In India, the research is very less in this field, humanoid robot. And to develop humanoid robot is very complex. See, it will have a number of independent joints and dependent joints. And controlling that joints is very difficult, because there will be number of motors, the motor size, weight, that all involves, and the robot control, it becomes, its dynamic becomes very complex. Now, regarding robot manipulator kinematics. Okay, so as you know, till now, as you know, what is the basics means, in what is the means, the term robot, from where it comes, what are the laws of robots, and what are the various applications of robots, and what are the parts of the robot. Now, we are going to deal about kinematics of the robot manipulator. So, as you know, kinematics, in which we don't study about the forces, torques. We study about motions. So there are two types of kinematics. This forward and inverse kinematics. And what is that? Forward kinematics. The forward kinematics, for the given joint angles, what will be the joint position? ठीक है? Means हमारा robot का tip कहाँ पर होगा? Suppose there will be theta 1, theta 2, theta 3, then what will be x and y in the case of planar? In the case of 3D, x, y, z. The difference between 2D and 3D, the in 3D we consider all three, x, y, z. But in the case of 2D, we consider about only two coordinates, whether x, y, y, z, z, x. So this kind of robot is known as planar robot. Okay? If we consider only x, y, so the robot will be planar robot. Means there will be, suppose, no height. Suppose z we are not considering, so height means the height of the robot we are not going to consider. So what is the kind of forward kinematics? The forward kinematics, where will be our manipulator, where will be our robot tip for the given set of joint variables. You can see here, x is a function of x, y, z. Means this x is a function of these angles, theta, x, y, z. It may be difficult. Better you understand कि फॉर द गिवन ज्वाइंट एंगल्स वेयर विल बी अवर मैनिपुलेटर. ठीक है, हमारा टिप पोजीशंस कहाँ पे होगा फॉर डिफरेंट डिफरेंट एंगल्स एंड व्हाट इज इनवर्स काइनेमेटिक्स द सेम फॉर द गिवन टिप पोजीशंस व्हाट विल बी द ज्वाइंट वेरिएबल्स. ठीक है, पहले वाला केस में क्या था, हमारा ज्वाइंट पोजीशन कहाँ होगा, रोबोट की टिप कहाँ पर होगा, और सेकंड में क्या है हमारा, चलो रोबोट का टिप का पोजीशन फिक्स्ड है, अब हमारा डिफरेंट एंगल्स क्या होगा, दैट इज नोन एज इनवर्स काइनेमेटिक्स. इनवर्स काइनेमेटिक्स डिटरमाइंस द आर्म कॉन्फिगरेशन थीटा फॉर ए गिवन पोजीशन एंड द ओरिएंटेशन ऑफ द एंड इफेक्टर. ठीक है, ओरिएंटेशन ऑफ द एंड इफेक्टर, जस्ट इफ यू कंपेयर विथ अवर बॉडी, सो हमारा बॉडी का जो कॉन्फिगरेशन है, कॉन्फिगरेशन मतलब जो पोजीशन है, ओरिएंटेशन है. ठीक है, तो उस पोजीशन ओरिएंटेशन के लिए ज्वाइंट एंगल्स क्या होगा, दैट वी फाइंड इन द केस ऑफ इनवर्स काइनेमेटिक्स. एंड इनवर्स काइनेमेटिक्स इज द प्रैक्टिकल प्रॉब्लम ऑफ मैनिपुलेटर कंट्रोल, मीन्स इट इज मोर प्रैक्टिकल. दिस इज द ब्लॉक डायग्राम, ज्वाइंट स्पेस, सपोज देयर इज अ ज्वाइंट स्पेस डिस्क्रिप्शन, आर्म कॉन्फिगरेशन, देन कार्टेशियन स्पेस डिस्क्रिप्शन, मीन्स अगर यहाँ पे ज्वाइंट एंगल्स है तो यहाँ पे क्या होगा, रोबोट टिप पोजीशंस, तो ये क्या कहलाएगा आपका, फॉरवर्ड काइनेमेटिक्स कहलाएगा. ठीक है, अगर ये आपका एक्स दिया हुआ है, रोबोट टिप पोजीशन दिया हुआ है, तो आपका ज्वाइंट एंगल्स यू हैव टू फाइंड आउट, दिस विल बी नोन एज आई के. आई के मीन्स इनवर्स काइनेमेटिक्स. नाउ काइनेमेटिक्स ऑफ ए प्लेनर सीरियल लिंकेज. देखिए आप प्लेनर, प्लेनर एज आई टोल्ड यू we considering only x and y and serial linkage. Serial means the number of links connected by the joints. So this is the example of serial manipulator. ठीक है, तो सबसे पहले क्या करना पड़ेगा हमें, सबसे पहले यहाँ पे coordinate fix करना पड़ेगा, यहाँ पे coordinate fix करना पड़ेगा. आप देख सकते हैं this x and y and this one will known as zero link. ठीक है, zero link मतलब robot का जो base होता है that is known as zero link. तो यहाँ पे क्या होगा, joint होगा. ठीक है, यहाँ पे joint क्या है आपका, theta one, then another joint here, this one, this is theta two, then the another joint theta three. So this is the example of 3 degree of freedom planar robot arm which consists of one fixed link. Fixed link कौन सा हो गया आपका, ये link 0. ठीक है, and the three movable links, ये आपका this first one, second one, third one, ये आपका movable because they are the three variables theta 1, theta 2, theta 3 and all are means all are actuated. Actuated means all are powered, all joints are powered, that's the way there will be movement. Now so how to get these kinematic equations, suppose this x is what, x e y e इज द एंड फैक्टर, मीन्स एंड फैक्टर आप देख सकते हैं यहाँ पे ई करके है ये, तो इसका पोजिशन क्या होगा इन एक्स एंड वाई डायरेक्शन, ओके सो हाउ टू गेट दिस एक्स ई, एक्स ई मीन्स एंड इफेक्टर पोजिशन ऑफ एंड इफेक्टर इन एक्स डायरेक्शन, वाई ई पोजिशन ऑफ एंड इफेक्टर इन वाई डायरेक्शन, सो हाउ टू गेट this xe, so xe will be this the position of end of the first link, you can see l1 cos theta 1 means aapka kahan tak ye from this horizontal distance, okay now aap dekh sakte hain plus l2 cos theta 1 plus theta 2, आप देख सकते हैं यहां से हमने जो एंगल जो मेजर किए हैं, एंगल जो मेजर किए हैं ये आपका लिंक के, लिंक को हमने एक्सटेंड कर दिए, अब एक्सटेंड करने के बाद जो अनदर लिंक है, तो अनदर लिंक और जो एक्सटेंडेड पोर्शन है, तो ये दोनों के बीच के एंगल दैट विल बी अवर द थीटा टू, ठीक है, सो दैट्स वाई अब यहां पे क्या हो जाएगा, यहां पे थीटा वन प्लस थीटा टू, बिकॉज दिस थीटा टू वी आर नॉट मेजरिंग फ्रॉम द एक्स एक्सिस, वी आर मेजरिंग फ्रॉम द एक्सिस ऑफ द प्रीवियस लिंक, ठीक है, तो आप देख सकते हैं l1 cos theta 1 प्लस l2 cos theta 1 प्लस थीटा टू, सिमिलरली इफ देयर विल बी थर्ड लिंक, so what will be plus l3 cos theta 1 plus theta 2 plus theta 3, similarly for y direction, in y direction what we have to get, we have to get this height from this, theek hai ye height hame milega, to yahan pe kya ho jayega aapka cos ke badle sin ho jayega, now what is this phi e, the phi e is the orientation of end effector, so orientation means that is equal to theta 1 plus theta 2 plus theta 3, whether people are listening or not.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. We are listening.
But are you getting? I am able to explain you.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So in between, if you if you want to ask any question, you can ask.
Sir, one student has asked one question. Shall I take it?
Yeah.
Sir, he's AT&T 8SEM student. He is asking, sir, which material is used to manufacture a robot?
Yeah, material. So I'm not dealing.
Okay, okay.
I'm dealing only kinematics and dynamics.
Okay.
So okay. material, जैसे actuator के लिए देखिए, जैसे actuator के लिए shape memory allow होता है. ठीक है. और
yes, sir.
और सेंसर्स आपका जैसे पीजो क्या बोलते हैं उसको, आई डोंट रिमेम्बर, यस सर, जैसे यहाँ पे एक आई एम गोइंग टू से Yeah, there is nothing about. And all these sensors and actuators are not part of robotically. Sensors and actuators are not a part of robot, and simply the link will be obviously the it will be मतलब जो एकदम light होना चाहिए, जो durable होना चाहिए, but exact yes. material I don't know. I'm not dealing means material kind of things. I'm dealing okay. only analysis part.
Okay.
Okay.
So any other question, student? Or any faculty want to ask? Sir, one question, I think.
Okay.
Sir, one student want to ask, sir, why robots are usually kinematic equivalent of animals?
Okay.
So, he is asking this question, sir, why robots are usually kinematic equivalent of animals?
Kinematic equivalent.
Hmm.
Means we can design like a dog kind of robot. That yeah, you are asking, that?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, there will be. There will be. If we compare with our human being, suppose our body and a robot, so obviously there will be number of similarities. जैसे जो आपका motor जो काम कर रहा है, motor आपका actuate कर रहा है, तो वो काम हमारा muscles कर रहा है, ठीक है? Muscles की वजह से joint में आपका movement हो रहा है. So obviously there are the similarities है, मतलब robotics and human being mein there are number of similarities.
Okay. So any other question, students or faculty? I think
okay, now
I think it's not okay. There,
now I am going to ask, right? What is a robot? Anyone? What is a robot?
So,
बताइए कुछ भी robot is a machine, automatic machine, क्या है?
So anyone want to answer it? Utsav sir, anyone want to answer it? Uday sir, Utsav sir, or any student?
Sir, robot is a reprogrammer manipulator which is used to operate a certain device for a special purpose.
हाँ ये तो ठीक है, इसका आपका application use बता रहे हैं, लेकिन है क्या robot है क्या?
Robot is an automatic machine that do the work what human can do.
No. Abhi bhi aap differentiate nahi kar pa rahe hain.
It's a programmable sir. Machine.
Yeah, you are right. Ha, matlab always there are two keywords. Always use reprogrammable and a multifunctional.
Yeah, exactly. Reprogrammable. Yeah, you are right.
ठीक है. तो robot क्या है? Robot आपका reprogrammable and a multifunctional automatic machine. ठीक है. What is the manipulator? Manipulator क्या होता है? Robot क्या है? Manipulator क्या है?
Sir, manipulator is the mechanical structure of robot.
Okay. तो mechanical structure robot में कौन सा नहीं आता? जो robot में आता है? फिर दोनों में डिफरेंस क्या होगा?
मैनिपुलेटर है तो
सीटेस। तो देखिए रोबोट में आपका सेंसर्स नहीं आएगा, एक्चुएटर्स नहीं आएगा, ठीक है? जब ये आपका मोटर्स हो गया, जब ये सब रहेगा तो वो रोबोट बन जाएगा, ठीक है? मैकेनिकल स्ट्रक्चर में अगर सेंसर्स रहेंगे एक्चुएटर्स मींस मोटर्स रहेंगे तो क्या हो जाएगा, वो रोबोट बन जाएगा, ठीक है। अब उसके बाद आपका प्रोग्रामिंग होना चाहिए ना, ठीक है। ये अगर तीनों चीज रहेगा तो रोबोट बन जाएगा। अच्छा, तो रोबोटिक्स से कितने लॉ से बता सकते हैं? कौन कौन से नियम है? एनीवन?
इट शुड नॉट इंजर एनी
थ्री लॉज,
एनी
हां डोंट ओबे द ह्यूमन ऑर्डर,
दे आर जनरली थ्री लॉज, ठीक है। फर्स्ट वन कंसर्नड विद द सेफ्टी ऑफ ह्यूमन बीइंग, सेकंड वन इज कंसर्नड विद the inspection of
order,
yeah, orders of human being. Third one is concerned with the existence
of the robot.
ठीक है। अच्छा, ये किसके द्वारा किया दिया गया था?
Asimov
कब दिया गया था?
1940
ठीक है। और रोबोट का मतलब कहाँ से डिराइव हुआ?
एक नॉवेल,
हाँ, एक चेक नॉवेल था, ठीक है,
हाँ,
उससे डिराइव हुआ। सबसे पहले रोबोटा करके जाना जाता था, ठीक है, अच्छा, और सबसे पहले इसका स्टार्टिंग एप्लीकेशन, रोबोट का स्टार्टिंग एप्लीकेशन क्या था?
फर्स्ट
रोबोट वॉज यूनिमेट, ठीक है, एंड दैट वॉज इंडस्ट्रियल रोबोट, ठीक है। और इंडस्ट्रियल रोबोट में क्या क्या फीचर्स हैं, क्या क्या इंडस्ट्रियल रोबोट के बेस फिक्स्ड होते हैं, ठीक है, मूवेबल नहीं होते, और उसमें कितने मिनिमम कितने डिग्री ऑफ फ्रीडम होते हैं?
वन
फ्रीडम क्या है?
सिक्स
सिक्स डिग्री ऑफ फ्रीडम होते हैं, ठीक है। अच्छा,
वर्क स्पेस उसका,
अच्छा हाँ, वर्क स्पेस, वर्क वॉल्यूम या वर्क स्पेस,
बोथ आर करेक्ट फॉर डिफाइनिंग द एरिया अंडर व्हिच द रोबोट कैन स्पेसिफिकली पिक एंड डू एनी जॉब लाइक पिक एंड प्लेस और एनीथिंग इट इज सब्जेक्टिफाइड।
या यू आर राइट, मींस the work volume or you can say work boundary or you can say work space, ये क्या होता है आपका maximum reach of the manipulator, ठीक है, कि आपका robot जहां तक maximum जहां तक पहुंच सकता है वो क्या कहलाता है? आपका work volume कहलाता है, ठीक है। अच्छा, और इसमें configuration क्या है? configuration term हमने use किए configuration, जैसे लाइक कंप्यूटर configuration होता है, ठीक है, डेस्कटॉप का
configuration is the
arm configuration
pose of robot,
okay,
consisting of orientation and position
in respect to the base,
the pose of your robot, ठीक है। अब pose क्या हो गया आपका? position plus orientation, ठीक है। अच्छा, ये बताइए क्या end effect है, robot का part है? किसको बोलते हैं सबसे पहले? एंड इफेक्टर रिस्ट के बाद,
एंड इफेक्टर जो होता
है, ठीक है, ये रिस्ट
के बाद, रिस्ट के बाद हम लोग एंड इफेक्टर को अटैच कर,
हां,
और उसमें हम लोग कुछ भी यूज कर सकते हैं, जैसे कि कोई वेल्डिंग टूल हो गया, या फिर हम लोग अगर उससे
स्प्रे पेंटिंग
का काम करवाने वाले हैं तो ग्रिपर्स हो गए, तो ग्रिपर्स हम लोग लगा सकते हैं एंड इफेक्टर के तौर पे, तो एंड इफेक्टर जनरली कंसीडर नहीं किया जाता है रोबोट के पार्ट में।
ओके,
एज अ पार्ट ऑफ रोबोट।
एंड इफेक्टर्स कितने टाइप के होते हैं?
There can be various end effectors as for the purpose, जैसे कि हम लोग अगर welding करना चाहते हैं तो एक welding torch लगा सकते हैं, और अगर हम pick and place का काम करवा रहे हैं तो pick and
place। End effectors, there are two types of end effectors, first one is gripper, second one is tool, ठीक है?
Gripper and second one welding, so any kind of tool,
ठीक है? तो ये आपका end effector हो गया, ठीक है? अच्छा, अब बात करते हैं हम रिडंडेंट। यू नो व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ रिडंडेंट? रिडंडेंट, रिडंडेंसी,
रिपीटेटिव सर, रिपीटेटिव सर, अगेन एंड अगेन, और वेरी बल्क ऑफ डाटा, इस टाइप की चीजों को रिडंडेंट
रिस्ट्रिक्टेड।
नो 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 नो, रिडंडेंसी मतलब
bulk of things that are certainly no longer useful or can be used for any other purposes, which can be matlab destroyed, such kind of things are redundant, like this repetitive are also a certain example of redundant, what you can say.
Ha,
like
no, redundant means suppose we are going to deal, yeah, we are going to capture any object, theek hai?
Yes.
So how many degrees of freedom required? मतलब आपको या तो x direction में, y direction में या z direction manipulation चाहिए, चाहिए ना आपको?
Yes.
ठीक है? तो कितने degrees of freedom हो जाएंगे? Six हो जाएंगे?
Six degree of freedom से freedom certainly.
हाँ. अगर six degrees of freedom से ज़्यादा है, मतलब क्या ज़्यादा है? If number of joints are more than required, then the robot becomes redundant. ठीक है? Robot क्या होता है आपका? Redundant हो जाता है, ठीक है? हाँ, और redundant हो जाएगा क्या हो जाएगा? Redundant मतलब क्या होता है? आपका number of joints बढ़ जाएंगे, ठीक है? Number of joints
actuators पे load ज़्यादा
आएगा। Actuators पे load ज़्यादा हो जाएगा, ठीक है? तो उसके बाद कंट्रोल करना बहुत मुश्किल हो जाता है, ठीक है? लेकिन वही आपका रियल एप्लीकेशन है। व्हाट अबाउट आवर, सपोज आवर हैंड, आवर हैंड इज वेदर रिडंडेंट और नॉन रिडंडेंट?
हमारा एक्चुअली एवरीथिंग इज यूजफुल।
In our hand, up to wrist, up to from the shoulder to wrist, we have 7 degrees of freedom. ठीक है? और चाहिए कितने?
6 degree of freedom.
6 चाहिए, 7 है, ठीक है? तो चलिए, इसके वजह से redundancy की वजह से हम क्या जानते हैं? The robot becomes complex, its controlling becomes complex, but
complex.
जब कॉम्प्लेक्स क्यों बनाते हैं ऐसा? व्हाट मे बी द रीजन? जब हम जानते हैं कॉम्प्लेक्स है करके, तो हमें ऐसा कॉम्प्लेक्स क्यों चाहिए? मतलब ऐसा कॉम्प्लेक्स रोबोट क्यों चाहिए?
एक्यूरेसी बढ़ जाती है।
हाँ, क्या बढ़ जाती है?
एक्यूरेसी।
एक्यूरेसी ठीक है, लेकिन आपको फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी, ठीक है? इससे क्या हो जाता है आपका? द रोबोट कैपेबिलिटी ऑफ रोबोट इंक्रीजेस, द फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी ऑफ रोबोट इंक्रीजेस, दैट्स व्हाई इट कैन अवॉइड द ऑब्स्टिकल, इट कैन रीच द नैरो स्पेस, ठीक है? तभी हम, हमारा बॉडी क्या है? रिडंडेंट बॉडी है, ठीक है? हमारा हाथ क्या है? रिडंडेंट है। तभी हम क्या कर सकते हैं? नैरो स्पेस से भी हम, सपोज है बॉटल को पिकअप करना है, ठीक है? तो हम नैरो स्पेस से भी कुछ पिकअप बॉटल पिकअप कर सकते हैं, मतलब नैरो स्पेस में ही हम कोई मैनिपुलेशन कर सकते हैं, ठीक है? ओके, शैल आई कंटिन्यू नाउ?
यस सर, वी कैन प्रोसीड फर्दर।
ओके, ओके, सो फॉरवर्ड काइनेमेटिक्स एंड इनवर्स काइनेमेटिक्स में बताया मैंने। सो इनवर्स काइनेमेटिक्स में क्या होता है, फॉर द गिवन टी पोजीशंस व्हाट विल बी द जॉइंट वेरिएबल्स, दिस इज नोन एज इनवर्स काइनेमेटिक्स, ठीक है? और इनवर्स, व्हाट इज द ब्यूटी ऑफ इनवर्स काइनेमेटिक्स, वी कैन हैव द मल्टीपल सॉल्यूशंस, ठीक है? या In the case of inverse kinematics, we can have multiple solutions. ठीक है? आप अपने हाथ को कहीं पे ले जाके देखिए, आप कोई टारगेट सेट कीजिए, ठीक है? कोई टारगेट सेट कीजिए और उस टारगेट में आप डिफरेंट डिफरेंट मोशन से आपको उस टारगेट तक पहुंचना है, ठीक है? Getting my point? को एक टारगेट से कीजिए और उसको आप कैच कीजिए, ठीक है?
यस सर।
आप उसी को देखिए, आप जैसे ये है, सपोज यहाँ पे कोई टारगेट है, तो चाहे तो मैं ऐसा भी उस पोजीशन में पहुंच सकता हूँ, मतलब विथ वेरियस सेट ऑफ ज्वाइंट वेरिएबल वन कैन रीच That target point, ठीक है? तो ये तो अच्छा हो गया ना फिर?
Yes sir,
ठीक है? हमारे पास बहुत सारे solutions हैं, means sir, suppose for theta one, we will have the different values. Theta one किसी time आपका 30 degree हो सकता है, किसी time आपको 40 degree हो सकता है, किसी time minus में चला जाता है, minus हो सकता है, ठीक है? So we will have number of मतलब number of ways to reach the goal point. So that is the beauty of inverse kinematics.
Inverse kinematics.
Okay. आप देख सकते हैं ये वाला फिगर देखिए आप. ये वाला फिगर देखिए. This is known as this one upper one elbow up and a down one the elbow down. आप देख सकते हैं दोनों का जो टिप पॉइंट है एक ही है. The tip point is same in both configurations. ठीक है? So it has multiple solutions. Means it has two solutions in this. Okay, now. Suppose for 2 degrees of freedom, theta 1, theta 2, we have to get what will be our robot tip position, easily we can get. Okay? Suppose there will be number of joints, and in the case of 3D, so is it so easy like 2D? Once again, suppose any robot is having the number of links, means number of joints, suppose n number of joints, and the robot works in the 3D, three dimension. Kya hum easily we can get its position velocity? No, we cannot get.
No.
We cannot get. That's why there is a convention, Dana-Waite-Hartenberg parameters. Okay? It is also known as Dana-Waite-Hartenberg convention. Okay? So, iske through, and there will be four parameters. In short, it is known as DH parameters. There will be four parameters. I am not going to detail. ठीक है, आपका अल्फा ए डी थीटा, ठीक है, अल्फा क्या है आपका, ए क्या है, डी क्या है, थीटा क्या है, अल्फा आपका ट्विस्ट एंगल है, ए क्या है आपका लिंक लेंथ है, डी क्या है आपका इन द केस ऑफ प्रिज्मेटिक ज्वाइंट, ठीक है, द ज्वाइंट में भी आइदर रिवॉल्यूट और प्रिज्मेटिक, रिवॉल्यूट में क्या किस मतलब वी विल गेट द रोटरी मोशन, बट इन द केस ऑफ prismatic we will get the linear motion. So as I am not going to detail, already it's 12 15 round. So by using DH parameters we can assign the parameters. Suppose this is a three links manipulator, means a 3 degrees of freedom. So how to get its parameters, so you can see for I need to go to understand, to make you understand I need to go in detail, but I think not necessary. Okay, one thing, you know what is transformations? You know what is transformations? In transformation, we want to know about the movement of the manipulator. Either it may be rotation, or it may be translations, or it may be combination of rotation plus translation. ठीक है? So homogeneous transformation में क्या होता है, इन द होमोजीनियस ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन द देयर विल बी वन मैट्रिक्स, मैट्रिक्स आपको किसके बारे में बताएगा, आपको रोबोट टिप पोजीशन के बारे में बताएगा, रोबोट टिप एंगल्स के बारे में बताएगा, विच इज नोन एज रोटेशन मैट्रिक्स, ठीक है, और जनरली क्या होता है, आपका जो मैट्रिक्स होता है वो आपका रेक्टेंगुलर होता है, ठीक है, तो क्या आप स्क्वायर मैट्रिक्स को, नो सॉरी, रेक्टेंगुलर टू रेक्टेंगुलर मैट्रिक्स कैन यू मल्टीप्लाई, यू कैन नॉट, डायमेंशन शुड बी सेम, लाइक द एलिमेंट्स इन द नंबर ऑफ रो, सॉरी एलिमेंट्स इन द रो शुड बी इक्वल टू द एलिमेंट्स इन द कॉलम, ठीक है, मतलब रैंक आपका सेम होना चाहिए, अगर रैंक सेम नहीं है तो क्या करते हैं हम, उसमें एक परस्पेक्टिव मैट्रिक्स करके होता है और आपका स्केलिंग फैक्टर होता है, ठीक है, तो हम मैट्रिक्स को स्क्वायर बनाते हैं, आप ये समझिए बस, ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन मैट्रिक्स में क्या होता है, मैट्रिक्स आपका स्क्वायर होता है, ठीक है, स्क्वायर बनाया जाता है, और उस मैट्रिक्स में क्या होता है, रोटेशन के बारे में मतलब द मैट्रिक्स विल हैव इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट द रोटेशंस एंड द पोजीशंस. आप देख सकते हैं ये आपका ये होमोजेनियस ट्रांसफॉर्मेशंस बिटवीन कंसेक्टिव ज्वाइंट्स, मतलब कंसेक्टिव ज्वाइंट्स मतलब सपोज वी हैव फोर ज्वाइंट्स, सो देयर विल बी व्हाट विल बी द फाइनल टिप पोजीशन, सो वी विल गेट बाय मल्टी, suppose there will be four joints, so there will be four matrix, and multiplying those matrix in sequence we will get the final tip position of the manipulator. Okay, now regarding dynamics of manipulator, so as you know we, in dynamics we deal about the motions plus the cause of motions. And why it is required? Dynamics, why it is required? Why not kinematics is sufficient? ठीक है, kinematics में मान लीजिए एक bottle ये आपका inside there is water, हम इसको pickup करते हैं, ठीक है, अगर यही अगर खाली bottle है तो pickup करते हैं तो हमें कैसा feel होगा, हमें कुछ वेट फील होगा अगर बॉटल
लाइट,
हाँ लाइट होगा, और अगर बॉटल के अंदर पानी है तो क्या होगा, हैवी फील होगा, ठीक है। लेकिन काइनेमेटिक्स में क्या होगा, हम तो काइनेमेटिक्स में ये चीज तो कंसीडर ही नहीं होगा। इन काइनेमेटिक्स वी विल बी नॉट एबल टू नो अबाउट द वेट इनर्शिया, ठीक है। तो क्या हम सही में डिजाइन कर सकते हैं, कोई ऐसा रोबोट डिजाइन कर सकते हैं या कोई ऐसा मतलब स्ट्रक्चर डिजाइन कर सकते हैं? नहीं कर सकते, ठीक है, क्योंकि उसका बिहेवियर अलग होगा और एक्चुअल बिहेवियर आपका डायनेमिक्स कंसीडर करना पड़ेगा, कंपोनेंट का कितना वेट है वो कंसीडर करना पड़ेगा, ठीक है। दैट्स व्हाई डायनेमिक्स रिक्वायर्ड। और इसका एप्लीकेशन क्या है, यू नो व्हाट इज अ मॉडलिंग एंड सिमुलेशन। डायनेमिक्स का एक और यूज होता है सिमुलेशन के लिए। सिमुलेशन में वी कंसिडर अबाउट द वट एवर द मासेस इनर्शियास ऑफ द बॉडी, देन वी विल गेट द एक्चुअल रिजल्ट, आवर वेदर आवर रोबोट सिस्टम रोबोट इज बिहेविंग प्रॉपरली और नॉट बिहेविंग एक्चुअल और नॉट, ठीक है। सो देयर इज अ वन मोर एप्लीकेशन ऑफ द डायनेमिक्स इन सिमुलेशन, ठीक है। नाउ आई एम आस्किंग यू नो अबाउट मॉडलिंग एंड सिमुलेशन, व्हाट इज मॉडलिंग, द मॉडलिंग इज इन विच इट इज द फिजिकल रिप्लिका ऑफ द सिस्टम। फिजिकल रिप्लिका मतलब क्या हो सकता है आपका, इन टर्म्स ऑफ मैथमेटिकल इक्वेशन हो सकता है, ठीक है, इन टर्म्स ऑफ प्रोटोटाइप हो सकता है, ठीक है, इन टर्म्स ऑफ ब्लॉक डायग्राम हो सकता है। मॉडलिंग क्या है आपका, मॉडलिंग आपका इट इज द
फिजिकल
रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ द सिस्टम, ठीक है। और सिमुलेशन क्या है, सिमुलेशन आपका जैसे जैसे आपका एक्सपेरिमेंटल वर्क में हम वैलिडेट करते हैं वेदर आवर मॉडल इज करेक्ट और नॉट, ठीक है। तो सिमुलेशन में क्या करते हैं, बाय वर्चुअल वे मींस यूजिंग कंप्यूटर वी वैलिडेट वेदर आवर सिस्टम इज प्रॉपरली वर्किंग और नॉट, ठीक है। हाउएवर देयर विल बी डिफरेंसेस इन द सिमुलेशन वर्क एंड द एक्सपेरिमेंटल वर्क, because there are number of terms we don't consider in simulation, but almost we will get close values, okay. So what I told you, the modeling is the physical representation of any dynamic system, simulation is the validation of that dynamic system whether it's performing well or not, okay. Now, there are different approaches for dynamic analysis. The first one, Newton-Euler approach, that is based on force momentum equation. ठीक है, न्यूटन नाम से ही पता चल जा रहा है, न्यूटन में obviously there will be force involvement, ठीक है, force balance equation. And the second one, Lagrange-Euler approach. ठीक है, इट इज बेस्ड ऑन एनर्जी क्राइटेरिया, ठीक है। थर्ड वन बॉर्नग्राफ टेक्निक, व्हाट आई एम यूजिंग इन माय रिसर्च वर्क, ठीक है। सो वी आर गोइंग टू फोकस ऑन लैग्रेंज डायनेमिक्स एज इट इज सिंपल एंड सिस्टमेटिक, ठीक है। अगर सिस्टम आपका सिंपल हो सो वी कैन ऑप्ट न्यूटन यूलर अप्रोच, ठीक है। अगर सिस्टम आपका कॉम्प्लेक्स हो, सिस्टम आपका मतलब जो आपका जिसका एनालिसिस करना है वो आपका कॉम्प्लेक्स हो, देन वी कैन गो फॉर लैग्रेंज यूलर अप्रोच, ठीक है। एंड द थर्ड वन बॉर्नग्राफ टेक्निक, इन लैग्रेंज यूलर अप्रोच वी नीड टू डिराइव एवरीथिंग, डायनेमिक इक्वेशन को हमें डिराइव करना पड़ेगा, बट इन द केस ऑफ बॉर्नग्राफ टेक्निक हमें एक ग्राफिकल रिप्रेजेंटेशन के थ्रू हम डायनेमिक इक्वेशन डिराइव कर सकते हैं ऑटोमेटिकली, ठीक है। The beauty of the third one, bond graph technique, is that for the given kinematic equations, one can derive the dynamic equations based on the graphical representations. Okay, so this is regarding Newton's formulation. As I told you, that is based on the force balance. So F is equal to ma in the case of linear, and in the case of a rotary, tau is equal to I alpha, and I is the what? Inertia, and alpha is what?
Angular.
Yeah.
Acceleration.
Yeah. Now Lagrangian formulation. Okay. So in the Lagrangian formulation, if you see the first one equation, see the structure of the equation. In the linear case, there will be F I, and there will be L term. So what is L? L is the Lagrange operator, is equal to K, and K is what? Kinetic energy, and P minus P, and P is what? Potential energy. Okay. So L is what here? L is the Lagrange operator is equal to kinematic energy minus potential energy. Now this L will be applied here. This L Lagrange operator will be applied here in the equation of force F I is equal to d by dt, means differentiation of this Lagrange operator with respect to the variable. ठीक है, variable आपका ये थीटा नहीं है, आपका ध्यान रखेंगे ये आपका x है. ठीक है, so आपका x i, और then minus the partial differentiation of Lagrange operator with respect to x. This is with respect to x dot, means velocity. This is with respect to that x only. ठीक है, so once again, this Lagrangian formulation we need to know about the system's variables. ठीक है, आपका q1, q2, qn, these are the system variables, means positions, and these q1 dot, q2 dot, these are the velocities, system's velocities. Okay, then Lagrangian, once again, that is L is equal to K minus P, and the Lagrangian formulation will be this one for linear, and this one for the case of rotational. Okay, now taking one example, suppose base is fixed. The robot base is fixed, and this is the point mass. We are assuming that the mass is concentrated at the end of the robot tip. Yeah, you can say at the end effector. And this is the link. The mass is negligible. The link length is here, capital L, and this is, मतलब configuration is theta is, means it is inclined with some angle theta with the horizontal axis, and see the tau, direction of tau is in the direction of rotation. So we can get the kinetic energy 1/2 m v square. And the v is what here, we will get v square will be x square plus y square. So we have to get the horizontal axis coordinate, then we have to get the vertical axis coordinate, then we have to square it. So that square will be, means square, squaring the square, then we have to differentiate to get the velocity, then we have to square. So we will get finally 1 by 2 m v square. This will be 1 by 2 m capital L theta dot square. In this way, the potential energy will be P is equal to mgl sin theta, this height. So in this way, we will get the Lagrange operator. Then we will, since it's a rotary kind of motion, so we have to apply the tau equation. Then by putting all those things, we will get ultimately the tau, means a dynamic equation in terms of torque. And this is regarding in the case of uniformly distributed mass. In earlier case, we have considered only concentrated mass, means there is a mass only acting only at the end of the robot. But here, the link is, the mass is distributed, uniformly distributed. And this is in the case of 2 degrees of freedom. It's difficult to understand in one go. Better you know a little bit, not in so much detail. Now, thank you. Yeah, any question?
Thank you, sir. If anyone can ask any question.
Dr. Bhulla, can I ask a question?
Yeah, yes, sir.
The good insight is for robotics, but we know difference between a robot and a human being is just mostly on two counts. One is intelligence, other is emotional. So we have seen the movies of the Rajnikant and some series on the Netflix.
Yeah,
so
yes.
A robot can be designed very close to the human being on a intelligent part, I think. But what about the emotional part?
So emotional part of by using artificial intelligence, we can do, sir.
But how close?
How close, sir? Means that it's a very question, is very nice question. But how close? It's a part of research, sir.
Okay.
It's a part
then
of research.
Then, just a small supplementary question. Is there any governing body who restrict the replicating the robotics as a human being?
Governing body that is based on that three laws of robotics. That governing body that is given by the means that laws are given by the ICMO and that robotics society of America. I think that is the main governing body.
Okay, thanks. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
I have a question, sir.
I have another question.
Actually, sir, what type of the gear is suitable for the motors? If is there any formula for the selection of the gears?
Yeah, definitely. It depends upon motion, which kind of motion you get. Okay, so obviously there will be.
Because I was trying to develop a robotic arm, and when I was using a warm gear, then it works very good. But when I tried to use a normal gear, then there was some issues with that motor won't be able to, that robot won't be able to pick up and place in that particular situation. So is it true that a warm gear is better than normal gear or what?
Yeah, definitely, sir. Warm gear will be better. Depending upon the application, but
yes, sir. but means it was in trial and error method. Means I was trying first that normal gear, then it was not working, then I try for the warm gear. So okay, it was the issue that is there any predefined formula for the selection of gear?
No, there is no predefined formula.
It means we must try and then
try
and test. Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you, sir. Anyone else who wants to ask any question?
Sir, I have a question.
Sir, can. Okay, we have another question.
Okay, just a little suggestion I want from your side. I'm a faculty in mechanical department. I just wanted to know if the names of some of the softwares that you use in your college to demonstrate or simulate the robotics robotic arm or robotics in your curriculum.
Okay. Yeah, there is one software, Symbol Shakti, which is developed by IIT Kharagpur, and now it's free. Symbol Shakti software is free, and there is one for kinematic part. There is one robo analyzer. If you go and search in Google, then you will find it is developed by Professor S.K. Saha, IIT Delhi. Robo analyzer.
Yes, sir. About that robo analyzer, I knew about his project and the robo analyzer software, what he is developing right now. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. So can we proceed further? Thank you, sir, for your speaking to all the students. We are grateful for the time and effort you took to explain the nuances of kinematics and dynamics of robots. Now, I cordially invite Uday Khaka, sir, Assistant Professor Mechanical Engineering, to coordinate students' feedback. Khaka, sir, please.
Thank you, Deepi, ma'am. Good afternoon, Principal sir, Anil Gopal Rane sir, Mukherjee sir, Mundan sir, and Umesh sir, and HODs and all my colleagues and dear students. First of all, I would like to thank Dr. Vijay Kumar Dalla for taking his valuable time for delivering a lecture in his subject of expertise. Also, now I like to request the students to give their genuine feedback. In this series, first, I would like to invite Tejaswar Shivas of ET&T 8th semester to give the feedback in about the following session.
Tejaswar, please. But sir, if you allow me, I want to share some inspiring story.
Sure, sir.
5 minutes only.
Sure, sir.
Yeah. Inspiring story kahan se start karun? If you go and see my profile CV, at the last there is one paragraph.
Yes, sir. About your parents.
Yeah, that is devoted to my family.
Yes, sir.
And that is means some kind of struggling, and but nowadays sharing personal things to student aise halke mein lete hain. मतलब उसको नहीं समझ पाते हैं, लेकिन फिर भी अगर कुछ अगर पॉजिटिव स्टूडेंट्स हो जो मतलब जिनके लिए मतलब कुछ हेल्पफुल हो तो मैं शेयर करना चाहूँगा. देख, सबसे पहले मैं ये शेयर करना चाहूँगा, जैसे आपने मुझे यहाँ सुने आपने, सो बिफोर ज्वाइनिंग जी सी बिलासपुर आई वॉज नॉट एबल टू स्पीक हिंदी, इवन हिंदी. I am from a small village near to Shakti, तो छत्तीसगढ़ी में बोलते थे, लेकिन जो वहाँ पे 13 महीने जो रैगिंग हुआ तो वो रैगिंग की वजह से मतलब कई बार ऐसे मतलब इंट्रो देना पड़ता था, तो उसकी वजह से मतलब बहुत बेइज्जती फील होता था, हेजिटेशन फील होता था, सब मींस हिंदी होता ही निकलता नहीं था. सो even I was not knowing Hindi properly, and there Now subjects were in English, so that was the biggest problem for me. तो मैं फिर वहां से जीसी बिलासपुर से गांव जाता था, अपने पेरेंट्स को बोलता था कि बहुत डिफिकल्ट है, सर्वाइव करना बहुत डिफिकल्ट है, तो वो लोग कुछ नहीं बोलते थे. तो फिर उसके बाद वो लोग कुछ नहीं बोलते थे तो फिर उसके बाद मैं पलट के बोलता, नहीं नहीं नहीं, मुझे आई हैव टू डू समथिंग बेस्ट. और मेरे पेरेंट्स तो एक समय ऐसा था के समय कि बाहर लेबर वर्क के लिए जाया करते थे, और वैसे में फिर इंजीनियरिंग का डिग्री लेना, और वो भी उस समय बहुत ज़्यादा रैगिंग हुआ करता था, आजकल तो बिल्कुल नहीं है. तो उसकी वजह से जो एकेडमिक परफॉर्मेंस जो बुरी तरह से प्रभावित हुआ, सो उसकी वजह से कॉन्फिडेंस लेवल भी बहुत डाउन हुआ, क्योंकि बिकॉज आई वॉज टॉपर इन स्कूल, आई वॉज टॉपर इन 12th, सेकेंड टॉपर, आई वॉज टॉपर इन 10th इन ओवरऑल स्कूल. सो वो एक बहुत चैलेंजिंग पार्ट था, लेकिन वहाँ जी सी बिलासपुर का जो स्ट्रगल था रियली वो बहुत काम आया. ऐसा स्ट्रगल कि जिसमें हर एक चीज सीखने को मिला, बहुत कुछ नया कुछ जानने को मिला, वहाँ का जो एनवायरनमेंट तो वो काफ़ी हद तक आगे ले गया. एक चीज़ और मैं शेयर करना चाहूँगा कि बिफोर कमिंग हियर आई वॉज लिटिल बिट फियरिंग, लेकिन अब ये भी आ गया, जो है सो है. एक जो होता है, जो हमारे में है सो है, अब उसको हम कुछ नहीं कर सकते. लेकिन स्टूडेंट्स, मैं आपको कहना चाहूँगा, अगर आप में अगर कोई बुराई है, आप में अगर कोई कमी है, बुराई तो नहीं कर सकते, कोई कमी है, तो आप उस कमी के पीछे एकदम से पीछे ना भागें, जो आप नहीं कर सकते, जो आप हैंडल नहीं कर सकते, ठीक है. आप कोशिश कीजिए, अगर आपके मतलब कंट्रोल में नहीं है तो आप अदर पैरामीटर है उसको आप इवॉल्व कीजिए. आप दूसरे डायरेक्शन में कैसे अच्छे से कर सकते हैं, जैसे मैं अपना एग्जांपल दूं, तो जैसे मेरे पेरेंट्स भी मतलब बचपन में रहा नहीं करते साथ में, तो ये जो स्पीकिंग जो प्रॉपरली होना चाहिए था वो हुआ नहीं. मतलब कैसे प्रॉपरली स्पीक करते हैं, मतलब शाम को शाम जो श आना चाहिए, रा को रा आना चाहिए, वो मेरे से नहीं होता था. तो उस समय बहुत बेइज्जती होता था, इवन स्कूलिंग के समय बहुत बेइज्जती होता था, लेकिन एट द सेम टाइम मैं उनको बोलता था कि देखना बेटा तुम कहाँ रहोगे, मैं कहाँ रहूँगा. अब ऐसा नहीं कि अभी मैं जहाँ हूँ तो बहुत अच्छे में, मेरे से भी बहुत लोग आगे हैं, लेकिन कई लोग ऐसे हैं जिनसे मैं आगे हूँ, तो ऐसी जिंदगी तो यही है. तो वो एक सबक, वो एक मतलब चैलेंज कि आई वॉज नॉट एबल टू प्रॉपरली स्पीक, हाउ टू फेस द पीपल, हाउ टू फेस द सोसाइटी, इट वॉज टू डिफिकल्ट फॉर मी. लेकिन मैंने सोचा कि जो है सो है, अब मेरे से नहीं हो सकता, मैंने कोशिश किया. आपको मुझे एग्जैक्ट याद नहीं है, बिलासपुर के हॉस्पिटल में जैसे बच्चों का एक टंग जुड़ा रहता है, जैसे मेरे दोनों बच्चों के जो टंग का टीप है वो जुड़ा रहता है, तो उस समय अपने बच्चों का तो मुझे मतलब पता हो गया था कि हाँ टंग जुड़ा हुआ है तो जो वर्ड्स है प्रॉपरली नहीं निकलेगा. तो हमने बहुत केयर किए IIT रुड़की में जब PhD कर रहे थे, उसी समय डॉक्टर से हमने उसको थोड़ा सा कट करवाना पड़ता है. लेकिन अब देखिए, अब ओनली उसमें कितना लगा, 500 रुपये लगा, ओनली द चार्ज वॉज ओनली 500 रुपीज, एंड आई वॉज स्ट्रगलिंग फॉर दैट टाइम. मुझे तो उस समय समझ में आता नहीं था, पेरेंट्स को बोलता था कि वर्ड्स क्लियरली क्यों नहीं निकल रहा है. तो एक छोटे से शहर या शक्ति में जाके मैं पता भी करता था, तो बोलते थे कि ये नहीं नहीं ये कुछ नहीं आप इग्नोर करो. लेकिन मुझे फील होता था नो, वाई आई एम नॉट एबल टू प्रॉपरली स्पीक, वाई आई एम नॉट एबल टू स्पीक क्लियरली. तो इवन सिम्स में भी जाता था, तो सिम्स में 2-3 बार गया, तो सिम्स एक डॉक्टर भी भगा देते थे, बोलते कि नहीं 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 सब नॉर्मल है, ऐसा कुछ नहीं है. और उसके बाद लेकिन 2-3 दोस्तों के साथ मैं एक हॉस्पिटल गया, वहाँ जो टंग का जो टिप होता है उसको कट करवाना होता है, नीचे जो बेस होता है वहां से जुड़ा आता है। तो मैंने कट करवाया, लेकिन मतलब ऐसे हैबिचुअल हो गया था कि जो वर्डिंग है, जो मतलब कल्टीवेशन करना चाहिए इसका वर्ड का, वो तो पहले से हैबिचुअल हो चुका था, लेकिन मैंने काफी हद तक बहुत सारे वर्ड्स क्लियर किए हैं, जो हम छत्तीसगढ़ी में जो शाम को शाम बोल देते हैं, शादी को शादी बोल देते हैं, तो वही शादी शादी वाला वर्ड्स निकलता था, अभी भी निकलता है बहुत। तो एक चैलेंजिंग पार्ट था, बहुत हद तक मैंने कंट्रोल किया, मतलब सीखा मैंने। इवन जैसे IIT बॉम्बे में मैं जाया करता था, वहाँ सिटी में जाया करता था, वहाँ मतलब काउंसलिंग लिया करता था कि मुझे कुछ कुछ वर्ड्स क्लियर नहीं हो रहे, आप क्लियर कराइए, तो कुछ कुछ वर्ड्स क्लियर हुए। इवन हैदराबाद में तो मैं 18 साल की लड़की के अंडर में ज्वाइन किया था। बिफोर ज्वाइनिंग हियर IIT जमशेदपुर, आई वॉज विद वन ऑफ द टॉप प्राइवेट इंस्टीट्यूट एट हैदराबाद। सो उस लड़की से भी मैंने काउंसलिंग लिया, उसने भी कुछ कुछ वर्ड्स सुधारे और जिंदगी ऐसी चल रहा है। हाँ, लेकिन मैंने ये कोशिश किया कि यहाँ भी अगर देखा जाए तो डायरेक्टर की नज़र में मैं अच्छा हूँ, अच्छा मतलब आई एम वर्किंग हार्ड, मतलब सो यही कहने का मतलब है, आप दूसरे डायमेंशन में, अगर एक आप में कमी है तो आप दूसरे डायमेंशन में एक्सप्लोर कीजिए, आप जितना ज़्यादा कर सकते हैं, आप ऑनेस्ट रहिए, हार्डवर्किंग रहिए, तो आप दूसरा जिसमें कर सकते हैं उसे बहुत कुछ अचीव कर सकते हैं। तो इसी के साथ मैं थैंक यू सर।
थैंक यू प्रोफेसर दल्ला। या उदय खाखा प्लीज।
दल्ला सर फॉर योर वर्ड्स ऑफ मोटिवेशन। नाउ आई वुड रिक्वेस्ट student of 8th semester ET&T, Tejaswar Shivas, to give his feedback on the following session. Tejaswar, please.
Thank you, sir. Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Tejaswar Shivas. I am very glad that our college organized this webinar. This type of webinar is very useful to us gain our knowledge in different fields. I am also thankful to our alumni, Dr. Vijay Kumar Dalla sir, for sharing knowledge and experience with us. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Tejaswar. Now I would like to invite Abhinav Tripathi of Mechanical 8th semester to give its feedback. Abhinav, please take over.
It's both our honor and privilege, sir, to have you in this session. The session which has started with the basic definition of robotics of multifunctional programmable and which has extended up to the future scope of robotics has provided us the immense part of knowledge and the various very smaller things which you have covered, like the basic difference between simulation and experimentation, the basic difference between path and trajectory. This has broadened the ways of knowledge and we have thinking more analytically. Thank you, sir, for explaining the whys of everything, like why kinematics is important, why dynamics is important. So we have at last the motivation which you have given us in your words of knowledge, which will be greatly beneficial to us. And thank you, sir, for the session. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Abhinav. Now I would like to invite Aishwarya from Mechanical 8th semester to give feedback on this session.
Ashwarya, please. Yes, sir. Thank you for the opportunity, sir. Good afternoon to all the dignitaries. This session on robotics has been quite helpful in understanding the various topics related to robotics. Clear explanation of kinematics of robotics has been very helpful. Dynamic part has been easily elucidated. It's quite complex for us to understand. But the things are pretty transparent now for us to understand it better. Thanks for sharing your very inspiring words of motivations. Thank you so much, sir. This webinar has been really helpful to all of us. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Aishwarya. Moving forward, I would like to invite Rishika Saluja, Mechanical 6th semester, to give her feedback on today's session. Rishika, please take over.
Yes, sir. Good afternoon, everybody. This session is very helpful for all of us, as I already attempted training under the robotics of KUKA robots, and the things are very much clear to me by the help of sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you, Saluja. Now I would like to invite Anvesh Vaid of ET&T 6th semester to give the feedback. Please, Anvesh, take over.
Good afternoon to all teachers and respected Dr. Vijay sir. Sir, your session was amazing for me. I, being from electronics department, I understood the basics of robotics, the importance of kinematics and dynamics, which I was completely unaware of. Thank you, sir, for making me aware. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Anvesh. Now I would like to request any other student who is willing to give the feedback, please take the stand and give his or her feedback. If there's anyone want to give their feedback on their own. I guess nobody is now willing to give the feedback. So without wasting any much time, I would request Vivek sir to take the mic and proceed the lecture, the session.
Thank you, Papa sir. Now, I would like to invite Dr. Imar Meshram sir, HOD Electronics and Telecommunication, for vote of thanks.
Respected principal sir, all head of the departments, all faculty members, and dear students, it seems to be a great honor to propose the vote of thanks to all who have helped us in making this webinar a very resounding success. So first of all, I would like to give my hearty vote of thanks to our principal sir, Dr. B.S. Chawla, for their valuable guidance, motivation, and support. I would like to thank our distinguished speaker, Dr. Vijay Kumar Dalla, Assistant Professor, NIT, Jamshedpur, and our 2006 batch alumni, for making an excellent presentation and making this webinar very meaningful and interesting. I also like to thanks for HOD, all HODs, for his guidance and moral support. I would like to give my vote of thanks to organizing committee, especially Professor Vivek Rathore, Uday Khan, who have stayed with us.
Hello. Sir, I think there is a technical glitch with Meshram sir. Hello.
Just ask him.
Meshram sir, are we audible? Hello.
Hello. There's a problem. There's a problem.
Yes, I think there is a problem. He's not audible to us.
Okay.
I think there is a network issue, ma'am. You can move further.
We can move further, and before concluding the session, I would like to recognize the presence of my batchmate and very eminent engineer of the country, Sri Sushil Kumar Sinha ji, from Reliance Industries. Earlier he was with ONGC. And Mr. Y. Srinivas has also attended the session. I thank all the alumni who spared their very valuable time. I especially thank Professor Vijay for giving a nice presentation and connecting him well with my students. And Professor Vijay, I request you,
yes, sir.
Please take at least one or two project work of our college as a joint guide for final year students in the area of robotics. One guide will be from my college, and one, at least as a co-guide, you can help them to understand robots.
Yeah.
So in future, for their PG and placements, that will help them a lot.
Yeah.
Thank you so much. Any other issue, Deepi?
Yes, sir.
Any other issue?
No, no, sir. So now we are at the verge of conclusion, sir. So
yeah, please announce.
Can I now conclude, sir?
Yeah, please.
Okay. At the end, thank you everyone for joining us for today's webinar, and I wish to see you in the future. Thank you so much for giving us your time and effort. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Thank you all.
Yeah. Thank you, sir. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.